Hey, this that Eastside Johnny Big Redemption like. Know what I'm talking about? Hold up.
Whoa, 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 whoa.
Get out the way, get out the way, get out the way, yeah.
Yeah.
Get out the way, get the f*** up out my way, yeah.
Yeah.
You either with me or against me, though. You either with me or
wait.
Win, 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 win.
Yeah.
Curve everything else. Win, 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 win.
Win.
These ops ain't lit.
Mommy.
Win, 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 win. Start chasing that chip.
Stop.
Win, 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 win.
Yeah.
Big J Rock go.
Go.
On 10, 10, 10, 10. Exit at 4. Bring friend, friend, friend,
friend,
friends. Jump in. You might wanna keep scope. I win, 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 win. Forearm tattoos. That's squad, 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 squad. All of them gon' shoot. Don't try, 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 try. I walk in room. They eyes wide, wide, wide. Third album come soon. I'm glad y'all gon' die. I ain't chasing after no. I got bigger plans than staying rich. I been tapped in since I was six. I tap dance all on a brick. And your diamonds like tap. Drip way too foggy. These BBS is way awesome. Park CLS for baby mama. Drop to your death without warning. Get out the way, get out the way, get out the way, yeah.
Yeah.
Get out the way, get the f*** up out my way, yeah.
Yeah.
You either with me or against me, though. On them like drow side, I got the bow side and the loud side. And if you act bad, I bring the cow side. Go and get your money, bitch. None of my hitters on some funny shh. I can tell real by who you're running with. I'm all in the field, duck hunt shh. Hit my plug just to re-up, and he was like, boop.
Here.
Migo knew just what it was. Flipped the whole dub and gave it back, boop.
Yeah.
9-11, no mileage, baby. 9-ball with no violence, baby. My trigger finger got callus, baby. My bare knuckles got talent, baby. I'm all in the wind with it. On deuce line, I been with it. She too fine, I been hit it. Crash 2 times, I limo tinted my new ride. I'm riding with the toaster. 12 better not pull me over. Championship going dumb.
Whoa,
nothing to something,
whoa,
I won.
Whoa.
Get out the way, get out the way, get out the way, yeah.
Yeah.
Get out the way, get
I've been saying, man, China is lying. They've been lying.
Look at this, man. Wuhan abruptly increases coronavirus death toll to 50% higher than previously reported. So this article right here is in the Business Insider. It talks about the central Chinese city of Wuhan, where the novel coronavirus first appeared on Friday, revised death toll almost exactly 50% higher. Local officials in Wuhan said earlier that deaths were missed because the city's medical facilities were overwhelmed, according to Chinese state media. Questions have long swirled about China's official figures. President Donald Trump said on Wednesday, do you really believe those numbers in the vast country called China? You know, China has a population, you know, population of well over a billion people. And they're saying that only 3,800 people died. I think that for them to show how that increase in death rate and death tolls that quick, how they revised it, shows that they've been lying. Look at this. The central city of Wuhan, where the novel coronavirus first appeared late last year, revised its death toll sharply on Friday. Local authorities changed the previous figure, 2579 to 3869. China's state-run Xinhua news agency reported. The change of 1,290 deaths is an increase of almost exactly 50%. Officials also added another 325 cases that have not led to death, bringing the city's total reported case to 50,333. All in all, man, look at this, man. The United States has lost. They added this. That's what the president said about this, man. China just announced doubling the murder. It's far higher than the U.S. Not even close. There you go, man. So, again, man, China is lying. They've been lying. This stuff, it's actually a lot worse. Look at this, man. Their economy has actually been down. First contraction in 20 years, 6.8%, an extraordinary shock to the global economy. We'll talk about that one next, man. So, as a matter of fact, let's go ahead and talk about it right now. So, China has an economy in 28 years shrinks 6.8%. So let's look and see what that means and how dangerous that is for their economy to shrink. So look at this. The economy shrank by 6.8% in the first 3 months of 2020, signaling the gloom for the country where the novel coronavirus emerged before spreading around the world. China's National Bureau of Statistics released economic data Friday showing major economic indicators declined across industrial production, retail sales, investments, imports, and exports. On the news of the data, American economist Maria Rubini remarked, you know, that the collapse in the first quarter was staggering. One investor described the contraction as an extraordinary shock. So, why this is dangerous? This is dangerous for a number of reasons. One, let's look at this. In China, male to female ratio. Okay. Gender ratio. Here you go. Here's an article right here. In China and India, men outnumber women on a massive scale. Look at this. It's in the Post. The consequence of having too many men now come of age far reaching. Beyond the epidemic of loneliness, the imbalance distorts labor markets, drives up savings rates in China, and drives down consumption, artificially inflates certain property values, and parallels which increase violent crime, trafficking, and prostitution in a number of locations. Those consequences are not confined to China and India, but reach deeper to their Asian neighbors and distort the economies of Europe and the Americas. So if you think about this, we see right here that the economy shrunk, right? The economy shrank, and the reason why is they had less spending, right? Retail sales, consumer goods by 19%, These men are not buying. They're saving this money. They're not making these purchases that a woman would normally make. That, you know, usually in societies such as China, the woman is at home. She does run the home, and man, it's a patriarchal society. So I believe it's a highly patriarchal society. But in the future, let me see, there'll be millions of men who can't marry. They can pose a very big risk to society. Out of China's population of 1.4 billion, there are nearly 34 million males and females, the equivalent of almost the entire population of California or Poland, who will never find wives or only rarely have sex. China's official one-child policy was a huge factor in creating this imbalance. Look at this, man. In the two countries, 50 million excess males are under the age of 20. So you got all these youngsters. Look at this, man. India, China. Whenever countries have more boys than that. Look at this, man. China, 115 male babies for every 100 female babies. 111 male babies for every 100 female babies. Look at this, man. The biggest gap between men and women of marriageable age defines 15 to 29 will come in the next few decades as the babies in the past decade grow up. And the factory in a large pool of both unmarried, older, and younger men vying for the same pool of young women, the gap becomes more of a chasm. Look at that. Village life among men, loneliness and depression are widespread. Villages are emptying out. Men are learning to cook and perform other chores and long relegated to women. With stagnant lives, housing prices and staying rate. Blacks are furiously building houses in China to attract wives, and prices are soaring. But otherwise, they're not spending. So even if they did have the coronavirus, right? Without the coronavirus, their economy still would have dropped. Because these men are not going to be spending money. Investment in fixed assets. What fixed assets are we going to be using as a manufacturing? So if retail consumer goods like washing machines, dryers, refrigerators, if the sales for those are down, then production are down. And then fixed assets, which usually is something like which is machine or equipment that you use in manufacturing, that will be down. So this is all makes sense. You know, if you just put things together, the math does not lie. It's about to be a lot worse for China, because I have a strong suspicion that, you know, we're not going to pay, that the United States is not going to pay, you know, not going to pay the debt owed to China right now. There's a lot of talk of that the U.S. is not going to pay the debt load. So yeah, that's all I got, man. Y'all tune in, man, for more, man. Subscribe to Blurred Planet, man. All right, man.
A Hubei resident publicly sued the Hubei government for covering up the CCP virus spreading. That night, he was summoned by police. China's economy shrinks for the first time since records began three decades ago, its GDP falling nearly 7%. Chinese authorities revised the virus death count in Wuhan, increasing it by 50%. Many believe the new number is still too low. Governments around the world demand the truth from China. They want to know how the virus originated and say it may have come from a lab in Wuhan. The G7 joins the call to reform the World Health Organization as Republican lawmakers call for its director general to resign. Welcome to China in Focus. I'm Tiffany Meyer. China's economy shrinks for the first time since record began 3 decades ago. Its GDP fell almost 7% in the first quarter. Factories across China shut down and exports fell. Many countries reevaluating their trading relationship with China. Even though Chinese authorities are urging companies to reopen, many analysts believe economic activity will remain low. An American economist tweeting, China's GDP figures show a depression rate of economic collapse. Chinese authorities are trying everything to get companies back to work, but many factories have no orders and many people have been laid off. One factory needed 50 new workers, 500 turned up for the interview. Since the beginning of 2020, over 5,000 movie and TV companies in China have closed down. That's an 80% increase versus the same time in 2019. And Chinese authorities revised the death count in Wuhan from about 2,600 to about 3,900, an increase of 50%. The official reason is late reports, misreports, or false reports. However, many say it's still very far from the real number. Chinese Caixin Net revealed that one funeral home received 5,000 urns in just 2 days. That's 1,000 more than the revised death count. One Chinese netizen writes, the authorities should launch an official website publishing the details of the deceased, so then family members of anyone who's not on this list can raise questions. This list can be continually updated, so we can eventually get an accurate figure. But would the CCP dare to do this? If they did, wouldn't people be able to tell their figures are fake? 6 cities in China are considered potential hotspots for the next outbreak, but the people in these 6 cities may not know it themselves. According to photos from Chinese social media, at one airport in southern China, people arriving from Wuhan or 5 other specific cities were told to take a different route than other passengers. On 2 airport arrival forms, passengers are asked if they are coming from the 6 places mentioned above. One of the 6 cities is Guangzhou. One resident writing, I only found out Guangzhou was a hotspot after reading chat room posts. The control measures are still very loose here. Many people don't even wear face masks anymore. Most people here don't know the situation is so serious. None of my colleagues know. Over the past few days, we reported on the situation in 3 of the 6 hotspot cities, Wuhan, Guangzhou, and Suifenhe at the Chinese-Russian border. This April 15th video from Suifenhe City shows many shops preparing to close. The person taking the video says the authorities say all shops except food shops need to close. World leaders are increasing pressure on China, frustrated by the lack of transparency over the virus origin. But inside China, many people believe the virus came from the U.S. A Wuhan resident told Radio Free Asia on Friday the propaganda department has been pushing the narrative that the virus came from the U.S. and are repeating it nonstop. Now, more and more people believe it's true. He told RFA 80-90% of people there believe the propaganda, and trying to convince them otherwise doesn't work. China's Global Times editor-in-chief boasted on Chinese social media that he mocked U.S. officials on Twitter. This comes after U.S. Defense Secretary Mark Esper on Thursday questioned the information coming out of China. Hu Xijing wrote on Weibo that he mocked Esper, saying only 7 people died in Shanghai, which neighbors Wuhan, while more than 10,000 people have died in New York on the other side of the world. But instead of getting praise, he came under attack. Many netizens asked how come he had access to Twitter when the rest of China does not, adding Chinese authorities should allow everyone in China to use it. A growing movement is taking the internet by storm as Thailand joins Taiwan and Hong Kong in solidarity against Beijing. But they've taken a unique approach, rallying together behind milk tea to form the Milk Tea Alliance. The movement was sparked after young Chinese nationalists, known as Little Pink, accused a young Thai actor and his model girlfriend of voicing support for Hong Kong and Taiwan online and attacked them. Soon, many Thais rallied together to protest China's authoritarian regime. The Milk Tea Alliance was among the top trending in Thailand on Wednesday. Netizens say it's the first time Thailand has joined forces with Hong Kong and Taiwan to battle China's 50-cent army. The FBI said on Thursday that foreign government hackers have broken into U.S. healthcare and research companies conducting research into COVID-19. The FBI spokesperson did not name any specific countries or organizations. A Hubei resident has publicly filed a lawsuit against the Chinese regime for its role in the pandemic. It's the first case of its kind in China. NTD Xu Wenrong has the details.
A Hubei resident says the government knew the virus could be passed between humans long before it announced it, the cover-up resulting in many lost lives.
Someone needs to take responsibility for this epidemic. It's a very serious matter. As a Hubei citizen, I think it's necessary to stand up and tell the Hubei provincial government to take responsibility.
Tan Jun works for a theme park in Hubei. On the morning of April 13th, he filed a complaint against the Hubei provincial government. He became the first person in China to file a lawsuit against the government for the spread of the CCP virus. In his complaints, he said, according to the state-issued investigation report of Li Wenliang case, human-to-human transmission had occurred by December 2019. However, Hubei Health Commission stated on January 11, 2020, no medical personnel found infected. No clear evidence for human-to-human transmission. They obviously downplayed the situation. He added the Hubei government's cover-up led to the fast spread of the virus, which overwhelmed hospitals and ICUs. Many patients didn't have a chance to get diagnosed or treated. Many people died, including a lot of medical staff. Ultimately, the entire province was locked down. The loss of human lives and economy is unprecedented. The complaint states two demands. First, the Hubei provincial government must make an apology in the Hubei Daily newspaper. Second, the defendant, the provincial government, pays all legal costs. Many Hubei residents support him. However, they're not optimistic about whether he can succeed.
Everyone should stand up. Every local government should take responsibility. Not just Hubei province, but the entire Chinese government should take responsibility. Of course we support the lawsuit. The problem is that the government doesn't care. In other countries, you can sue the government. But how's that possible in China? The police will come looking for you.
The police summoned Tan Jun the night he filed the lawsuit. They told him to write a letter promising not to post anything related to the lawsuit online. And it's not...
现在公开是40个送到了武汉，40成以30啊，那就是1,200，是吧？就这就1,200，那这是放哪呢？就是那个所谓的新仓医院啊，雷神山医院，这个东西往这个医院下边的门挖个洞一怼，往这一怼，就像那个大货车往后卸货一样，一怼，楼上的人死了，直接从上面扔下来，吧唧啊，扔下来，然后呢一个抓钩把它拉进去，这个人咻就没了，啊，咻就没了。 这位战友说，他不是送了40个，全国已经有40万个在分发，说现在要下100万马上生产的量，100万，100万个移动式火葬场，一个就乘以30，多少3000万，一天就给你可以烧掉你3000万人，就烧掉2个女战友们，你瘆得慌吗？你害怕吧？你从前线进去的人，前一批全是死了出来的，3000个护士医生感染，仅仅武汉。 你还相信那2000个的数字吗？2000个人，他会给你准备40个移动化炉吗？不说武汉的47个火葬场，每个火葬场的19个生产线，47个火葬场在武汉的，不是湖北的，湖北是多少？算算大家，湖北怎么也得2000个吧？2000个湖北的火葬场，最起码一天烧你10万人没问题吧？你说他死多少人吗？你相信只感染了7万人吗？昨天我在直播的之前。 我和一个某国的官员，他说他们到底他们为什么要这么做，要掩盖真相？我说真相如果真是来自于蝙蝠，来自于动物，它不需要掩盖。